do. Two guys that have two of the greatest jobs ever is that they get to come into a theater and to present Disney's The Lion King, the Broadway musical. And they're doing that now at the Detroit Opera House through March 10th. Tickets still available. You can go to the Fisher Theater box office, Detroit Opera House box office, Ticketmaster, all the usual places. And what a pleasure and privilege it is to welcome into the studio at an ungodly hour for actors, Nick Cordileone, who plays Timon.
Yes, thank you.
Nice to have you, Nick. And Ben Lipitz, who plays Pumba.
Hi.
Nice to have you both here. You played a lot of roles. I mean, but this one has got to be the most fun.
It's definitely the most gratifying. Everyone loves Timon and Pumba. They're the everyman, and I really think the walking embodiment of Hakuna Matata. No worries.
No worries at all.
I think everybody wants to be like that.
And I would think, Nick, it seems to me, both of you guys, Ben Lipitz and Nick Cordileone, have played a lot of serious roles, a lot of different things, movies, television, legitimate theater on the stage. What I noticed when I saw this show, what gets me, though, is from when watching it on stage, you have to not only act, take the character, do the role, but you got to be a puppeteer. You got to move things around completely unlike what you would be doing if it were just you playing the role. Doing the role and doing the puppetry, that's challenging.
It is, but the really great thing about the Bunraku puppets, it's a Japanese art form of the puppetry that Timon and Pumbaa fall under, is what's really great is that we have to kind of stay out of the way of the puppet. I think the most successful actors in The Lion King learn how to channel the performance through the puppet so that they're not kind of peeking around going, hi, look at me, but more telling the story, really utilizing the puppet to tell the story.
Interestingly enough, in fact, Nick started off as an audition reader.
Yeah, exactly
right.
You
were reading against the people who were auditioning.
Yeah. So I got to play everybody in the show. I was Scar, I was Nala, I was Simba, I was young Simba.
Give me a little Scar.
Scar, well, a funny story. I hadn't seen the show in a while, and so he has this line where he calls out to Sarabi, you know, get in here, you know, you need to go hunting. And they had been saying, you know, play it off the back foot and very sort of not, you know, just not a fop, but, you know, very sort of this kind of thing. So I just called out, Sarabi. And they were like, burst out laughing, saying, no, he's a little angrier than that at this point. I was like, oh, it's not just Sarabi.
Well, it's a great thing to be able to be the audition reader and to have somebody. I know you weren't out to steal anybody's role, but the fact is they got smart and said, hey, why wouldn't you consider a part? Would you? And the rest is, as they
say,
as they say, is history. React generally the same, enjoying what you're doing?
Some audiences are a little more provincial than others. Detroit is tearing the theater down.
They're loving it.
Mm-hmm. Some cities are a little more staid and respectful. They'll come into it. They'll get more involved as the evening goes on, but usually by the end of the night, it feels like a rock concert.
I hope that even if you've seen it, and especially if you've just seen the film, you really should go see the stage production of Disney's The Lion King. If I could ask Nick Cordileone, Timon, and Ben Lipitz, who plays Pumba, to give us a little of that other favorite. There are three favorite songs. We played one earlier, Can You Feel the Love Tonight? We've got The Circle of Life, and then, of course, your big song.
Hakuna Matata ain't no passing craze.
It means no worries for the rest of your days.
It's our problem-free philosophy.
Hakuna Matata.
Thank you, guys.